Invite my wife to come help me out. I believe we have some non-tongue speakers are here today, and we pray that the Lord will help us and that we can all share, amen, what the Lord wants to speak to us today. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible, please, let's all read the book of Psalm 133. I think it's on the screen. Let's all read it together. Praise the Lord. 2-3. How good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. It is like precious oil poured on the head, running down on the beard, running down on Aaron's beard, down on the collar of his robe. It is as if the dew of heaven were falling on Mount Zion. For there the Lord bestows his blessings, even life forevermore. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's all read the Talmuds. Ua tol. Makai kemulele, bemono fafi mare, anofo fataha aipaima, iefi ofo ofani. O te tāia, moi lolo mahu inga ki he uru, aia nā tatehifo ki harakawa. Io koe harakama o e rone. Te aluhifo ke kapa o hono ngahi kofu. O hane koe hahau o hea moni. Me hane koe hahau na e tō ke ngahi unga o Sione. E nai whekau ki ai e sova ai monu ki ai. Io koe mohui tai ngata. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Today I want to share with us a theme. It says, the power of unity. Amen. Amen. The power of unity. I believe that unity is one of the, I would say, the powerful force that a group or family or church can ever face. Amen. Praise the Lord. The scripture that we've read this morning, it's David, they're about to put David into a king. Amen. And when David came, he saw all the Israelites getting together for the coronation.
Praise
the Lord. And as David was sitting there, he looked at the people gathered together. And for him as a leader, he looked at them not as a people to be like a slave to him or anything else. Or even he looked at himself has the authority to control the people. But what David saw was a bit different. David looked at the unity of the people. Amen. David looked, there's a hidden force behind this group of people. Praise the Lord. Amen. The powerful behind these people when they come together. Praise the Lord. And that's what David looked at as a leader. Amen. So today, as we look at, as we're about to advance through this conference, I want to encourage us, amen. As we come together, there is a powerful force behind us that we sometimes we do not recognize. And this powerful force can apply to the church. It can apply to your family or any other society or country.
Yes.
And that's what I'm going to talk about today, is the power of unity. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. David looked at the people coming together. Hallelujah, as I shared for us today. He's about to be the king of Israel. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you look at the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, chapter 4. Praise the Lord. Ecclesiastes, chapter 4, verses 7 to 12. We're going to read this verse. It is the same person. It was Solomon the wise man. He talked about the power of unity here. Glory to God. From verse 7, what I'm going to do, I'm going to read the English, and you guys are going to read the Talmuds. Ecclesiastes chapter 4, verses 7 to 12. Have you got it? Amen. Then I returned and I saw vanity under the sun. Verse 7. Solomon recognized something that is meaningless here on earth. And he said in verse 8, there is one alone, and there is not a second. Yeah, he hath neither child nor brother. Yet is there no end of all his labor, neither is his eyes satisfied his with riches. Neither saith he, for whom do I labor and bereave my soul of good? This is also vanity. Yeah, it is sore travail.
Someone
look at someone being alone. And he says, this person say him no son, him no brothers. And he looked at them being alone, and someone said, it is a vanity, because if he works, he cannot satisfy the richness of his soul, the desire of his soul. And someone also recognized, because he has no son or he has no brother, whom he's going to work for. Or the other word, what he's going to use the money for. So the first thing that Solomon looked at is working for nothing.
It's
working for nothing. He looked at that single person on his own. He said, there'll be coming to a time, maybe you work, but because you don't have anything with you or anyone with you, and he said, you're working for nothing. In verse 2, he said, on verse 9,
verse 9.
Decida.
He realized the second thing. He said, two are better than one because they have a good reward of their labor.
Decida uleleha que el tocoa y tocoa y tocotahaje viay a toton lele y enamawe.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's, you know, we're talking about the power of unity here. Solomon looked at one person works for labor. He only had a
few.
But Solomon said, look at the power of unity. Amen.
Amen.
But Solomon too, look at two people working together. They have high labor, have high money, amen, income. So that's the second thing that Solomon recognized when people come in unity, amen. Good return in labor. Verse 10. For if they fall, the one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him that is alone. When he falls, he hath no other to help him. So the third thing that Solomon recognized here, the power of unity, we are helping one another. Amen? We are helping one another when we work together in unity. Solomon said, if you're alone and you fall, nobody will lift you up. But if someone with you, he will lift you up. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let's look at verse 11. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat or warm. But how can one be warm alone?
Koeni foki kapau eta koto ato kowa tena maafana kae maafana fefe hataha iene tokotaha pe.
Amen. The power of unity.
Hallelujah. Koe maaloi oi ngawe fataha.
The power of unity, it will keep you warm. Amen.
Koe ngawe fataha ogune faka maafana iko.
Solomon said, how can one person be warm by himself or herself?
Pehe Solomon eanga fefe ke maafana aito kotaha.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And let two, amen, lay together, they'll keep themselves warm. It talks about our relationship. Amen. Sometimes, you know, I miss you guys when we don't come together as a church. And when we come and nobody, you know, somebody missed the church, you know, we feel like missing that person. I don't know whether you miss me or not when I'm not around, but but you know, when we come together in unity, it keeps the warm environment of being together as a church.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The power of unity. Glory to God.
Amen.
Give a hand to the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Morning was a bit colder the last few months when he was on alone by himself. See, now it's getting a bit nice and brown. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 12. And if one prevail against him, who shall withstand him? And a threefold cord is not quickly broken. Or number five, someone looked at it and he said, coming together, we are getting stronger. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If someone is against you, let's say you have a brother with you. I'm sure you defeat that person. In three courts, it's stronger. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Look at the power of unity. When we come together, we work for something, for mission. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was sharing with Molo as we came, you know. I said to him, you know, sometimes, you know, we go through mountains and valleys in life.
But,
you know, in church, in family, in community, in whatever. But people with vision, amen. They hold on no matter what.
Amen.
You know, you go work, you thinking about your children, you think about the table, what are you going to put on the table, you think about bread or clothes for them, and you work hard because you have a vision in your mind. If you're alone, you don't work for nothing. You just work for nothing. Maybe you want to desire to meet the desire. Working together, we'll give you a good return. The power of unity will help one another. Amen. Let's grow. Power of unity will keep us warmer. Amen.
Amen.
Not only that, will keep us stronger.
Give
a hand to the Lord. Hallelujah. In the book of Psalm 133, David used two examples. The examples that he used was oil. Not only that, but he used the morning dew. You know, oil and morning dew, they are something very special. I sat for a while and think about why David used those two things to illustrate the importance of coming in unity. You know, unity sometimes is not easy. Hey,
Fungani.
Sometimes it's not easy trying to keep us in unity. Because you have a different mind. I have a different mind. You have different thinking. I have a different thinking. You grew up in a different environment. I grew up in a different environment. And there's a saying in leadership, wherever are two people, you expect problems. But as we look at oil, you know, we notice these things. Oil was made from crushed substances. The oil that we talked about here is a different oil that they used, a special oil that they used to anoint the priest of the Old New Testament. Now this oil was made from olive leaves and olive fruits. Are being crushed together. You cannot have this precious oil until the leaves are crushed.
I
believe you all understand in our Tongan culture, we make lolo in Tonga, oil in Tonga. The old ladies used to go up there and pick all the fragrance leaves and stuff and crush it. And then the oil is being produced. Amen.
Amen.
Not only that, the second thing about this oil, after the oil was produced, it was dedicated to be holy for sanctification. Amen. Aaron and the priest could not do anything until they've been sanctified with this oil or anointed with this oil.
Amen.
Special oil. And number three, David looked at it and he said, this oil was very precious and bearable.
Amen.
Precious, you know. When Jesus was in the house, this lady came with this precious oil. Amen. And poured it at Jesus' feet. One of his disciples were jealous about this lady because it was so
bearable.
But as we look at the nature of this oil, amen, it brings us to the idea of coming together as unity is not an easy thing. Sometimes we've been crushed with the circumstances in life. But people won't understand you until you've been tested. Amen.
Yeah.
The fragrance of the oil cannot be exposed until it crushed. How can the people know that I'm long suffering until they see me getting angry or self control? How can they tell that I'm self controlled if I'm not angry? If I'm not putting it to test, amen. So, you know, unity, amen, it's not easy as I see. But unity, people can tell us as a church whether we are united together when we go through problems.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Until we are crushed, amen. But let me tell you, if we endure through the circumstances, hallelujah.
Amen.
God will approve you, hallelujah.
Amen.
For his work, amen. Hallelujah. And you'll be dedicated and sanctified to the work of God. And you will become valuable and precious in the sight of God. Hallelujah. So what I'm saying is, David looked at the people coming together in unity. David knew it's not going to be easy.
David
knew it's going to be hard. He knew that things will be a bit rough sometimes. But he thinks to himself, it is a blessed, amen, it's precious when people are coming together in unity. Praise the Lord. Amen. And that's the greatest power behind a group or family or church coming together when they come together in unity no matter what. Amen. You know, to prove someone's faith,
where
you need to come to a point where you say to yourself, no matter what. Amen.
Amen.
No matter what. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm still willing to work together in unity. The second example that David used, he said, coming in unity is like a morning dew. Morning dew is a collection of all kinds of water, water evaporated from the earth. All kinds of water, dirty water, clean water, sea water, whatever water, being evaporated and being collected up there. Amen. And together they will cool the hotness of the earth. Amen. When the earth is getting hot, the night comes, and in the morning dew comes down, and it cools, amen, the hotness of this earth. You know, when we come into unity, doesn't matter how hot it was last few days or last few weeks. When we come in unity, it cools down all the hotness in our life. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And lastly, the morning dew refreshes and moistening the ground and the plants. You know, when we have, sometimes we have meetings, sometimes we have some argument and things like that in at home or in church or board meeting or something like that. You know, and when it comes to a point that we all surrender, you know, and to a point where we reconcile and surrender to one another, you feel the heart is gone. You feel refreshes. You feel cool. You feel refreshes. And you feel like a green plant. Amen. Planted beside of the water.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
And that's what we're talking about here, the power of unity.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. So to conclude this message, we see that these two examples, they were both made from a tough circumstances. The oil was made from a crushed substance. The morning deal was made from a very cold cloud from the air.
But
if you only crush one leaf and use one leaf, you cannot have oil. Amen. Only when they come together, hallelujah, only when they come together, even though they are crushed, but they come together, they produce great things. You cannot have a morning dew with only one water particles. But when they all come together, up there it's very cold. When you fly in the plane, you see the temperature outside is minus what? It's very cold up there. As they come together, they fall down as a morning dew. They cool the hot surface. Amen. Together they produce great results. But David said, hallelujah, is on Mount Zion. Some people, they think it's part of the mountains, Zion, but that Zion starts with S. The Zion. It starts with S. The Zion that David was referred to starts with Z. Amen. And that Zion is in Jerusalem. Amen. It refers to the house of God. That's where God dwells. Amen. Where can you have the oil? Amen. The oil in the morning dew. The wonderful things about it, that's where the everlasting life has been commanded. Amen. That's where the everlasting life has been bestowed. Praise the Lord. And that's the highest goal or the highest purpose of being coming or uniting together. So that we will inherit the everlasting life. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't be on your own. Don't be isolated. As you come to the house of the Lord, remember that we are in a big family. Amen. We need to come together. We feel warm. We feel strong. We feel refreshed. Hallelujah. We feel like we feel we're like working together for vision. We see someone fall, we lift him up. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And I believe it's important for us because we can only have that in Sion, and not only that, that's where the everlasting life has been commanded. Let's all bow our head. Hallelujah, Jesus. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. We thank you for your people today, oh God. I don't know what they've been through, Lord, in life. I believe that it's very hard, oh God. Sometimes we go through hard things in life. We've been crushed by our friends. We've been crushed, oh God, by the community, by the environment. Sometimes we feel cold and isolated sometimes. But Father, we thank you, Lord, that you call us for unity today. It is much stronger for two people to come together. Much warmer. And even though we've been crushed, we've been cold sometimes, but you're still calling us to be united together. Father, I thank you for your people today. I pray, oh God, for their lives, whatever they're going through in life. I pray, oh God, that they will stand strong. United together, oh God. Working for purpose. Working for vision, that we will inherit the kingdom of God. Father, we don't want to miss it. And we know, Lord, that we cannot have it from anywhere else. But it's only in Zion. Only in Mount Zion. Yes. Father, we thank you for your people today. Bless them mightily. Bless them mightily. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.